The ultimate goal of human life is to go back home, back to Godhead, back to Sri Krishna. And our positions are very much like that of a small child who has left the hand of the father in a marketplace and got busy playing some toy and ultimately lost way back home. And while the child is playing this game, you see, there are different stages, and every time you make a wrong move, then your game gets over. So our position is very much like this. We are into this game, and if we play the game right, we will go back home, back to Godhead, to our dear father. And the stage one is the Nisheda Vratas. We don't eat meat. We don't indulge in intoxication. We don't indulge in illicit relations. We don't indulge in all the four rules and regulations. And we do it well. We cross the stage one. And then the stage two is all the vidhivrata. We chant our rounds, we take prasadam, we associate with devotees, we read Bhagavatam, we do our sadhana. But the stage three is the ultimate one. And the condition for the stage three is a little difficult. So here Krishna has laid down a rule. He says at the end of the life, whatever you remember, that state of mind which you are in, you will achieve that body. So now that stage three is a little difficult. So here Krishna says, yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tejatante kalevaram tam tam eveti konteya sadatad bhava bhavita. Whatever you remember at the end of your life. Now the good thing about this video game is every time that you lose in the stage one or stage two or stage three, you don't have to go back to stage one again. You just start from the stage you have left, because Krishna says in Gita, Neha Bikrama Nashosti Pratyavayu Na Vidyati Svalpam Apyasa Dharmasya Trayate Mahato Bhayat. But the difficult point is stage three, because Krishna didn't make it very easy. It sounds very simple that you simply remember Krishna at the end of your life and you can go back to Krishna. But to remember Krishna is very difficult. So Krishna didn't make it simple. He didn't say that you need to be wealthy to go back to him. He didn't say you need to be intelligent. He didn't say you need to be beautiful. He didn't say you need to be famous. What he simply said is that you have to remember him. Now, sometimes it apparently so happens that maybe you are in the middle of the devotees, maybe they're chanting, maybe Krishna's photo is right in front of your eyes, maybe Giriraj Shila is on your head, maybe Tulasi is on your tongue, maybe Ganga is in your throat, but there are still chances you may not remember Krishna if you haven't done it whole life. Because we have seen that practically sometimes, you know, some of our life members or some donors who are leaving body, or sometimes we visit a hospice and we try to make all the arrangements to make sure that the person can remember Krishna, but still it is so difficult to bring Krishna in their remembrance if they haven't done it before. Of course, for devotees it happens easy because they did it whole life. In fact, for devotees, if at the end of their life they are put in a situation where there is no access to Harinam, then there is no access to Krishna, Radha Krishna's photo, where there is no access to Tulasi, maybe there is no access to the association of devotees, you are in the middle of a road accident, but devotees still can remember Krishna because they did it whole life. So remembrance of Krishna is so difficult. Sometimes I've seen, if you put everything around the person, you know, everybody's chanting, making the person remember Krishna, but that it may happen that that Krishna is not in their remembrance. Maybe that person is thinking about what's going to happen with that property, which son is going to take which flat, what will happen with my insurance policy. There may be so many things going in your mind. That means to get Krishna in your mind is not so easy unless and until you do it whole your life. So, manmana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. Krishna says that atma parayan, mame vaishati yukta vaivam atma nam mat parayana. You have to think about Krishna. So that means, unless and until we practice it, right? Unless and until we practice it whole life. I'm reminded of this very funny, famous example of Srila Prabhupada, wherein he says that an old lady was at the bedside of a dying man and telling him, you know, chant, 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 and he says, can't, 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 you know. He says, can't, can't, but he doesn't chant, you know. So it may so happen. That means we need to do abhyasa. We keep doing and we keep doing. So then at the ultimate end, we will be able to remember Krishna easily. Right, so that is why Krishna is so very kind that, you know, he has brought so many opportunities in our life where we can increase the intensity of remembering him. So we just had a great Purushottam month just a fortnight ago, and now we are again back with Kartik month, and then again we will have Gaur Purnima, and then we'll have Narsingh Chaturdashi, and then Ram Navami, and then Rath Yatra, and then Janmashtami, and then we keep going whole year, and that way we train our mind and we dovetail our desires and we bring the senses in service and remembrance of Krishna.
Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna.